community that I live in is super special. So it's easy proximity to the city and all of the, you know, big attractions, your concerts, your professional football or baseball games, but yet we're tucked away in a little, you know, nook of suburbia. So there's three golf courses out here. They're all three of them unique, different in their own way. You have Blackstone Country Club. Blackstone's got a phenomenal country club, restaurant, tennis courts, you name it. Saddle Rock Golf Club, you know, they've also got the golf shop, swimming pools, their amenities are awesome. And then the Valley Country Club golf course. Here we are at Grandview High School, which is perched in Southeast Aurora, right off of Arapahoe Road. Again, easy proximity to everything. You've got Denver Tech Center just a few miles west, E-470 just a couple of miles east. And E-470, as you know, connects everything. It takes you directly to the airport. There's a train from the airport to downtown. This is really a really savvy place to live. I began my real estate career in 2004, which is when the market really began to tank. It was a blessing in a way because it really taught me that hard work and persistence was the only way to succeed. What sets me apart from other realtors is my work ethic and tenacity. I am a certified negotiations expert and highly trained on how to either get you the most for your home or to get the home that you love. My negotiation skills ensure that your money is never left on the table at closing. My clients have the most exposure and presence on the big dog real estate search engines, which translates to quicker sales for my sellers. Working with an experienced agent will definitely benefit you. Just like you would really want an experienced surgeon to operate on you, it's extremely important to have an agent with experience in not only real estate, but the actual area where you are either buying or selling. Area experts really do have an edge on other agents. What makes my business unique is the marketing dollars that I spend in the Southeast Aurora Centennial area and my deep roots within the community. I love to experience the look on my client's face when they walk into the home, and it's the one. It's the best, and that's really what it's all about.
Maureen's been great. We've used her several times in the last few years buying and selling houses. She's been a great advocate, always very reliable, very present.
Maureen really helped us get into our dream home, and we wouldn't have gotten here without her.
You can always reach me day or night. I look forward to assisting you.
Hi, I'm Mari Tambori. We're at 3800 Dahlia Street at not only an amazing company, Sausage Polidori headquarters, but also a really amazing family. So 94 years this year.
Yes. 94 years and still running.
So tell me a little bit about the timeline.
So, you know, my grandmother and great grandmother, my grandfather moved here from Utah because my grandfather had black lung disease and came to Colorado because of the cleaner air.
Your name is very well known,
right?
In Denver.
We're at Coors Field. We're the official sausage of Coors Field. So you can find it in there. We also do CU, CSU, and DU too. So we've done quite a few places.
So our college kids will be well fed when they out to college.
I would hope so.
So how is it made from beginning to end?
Well, pork shows up at the dock, bring it in, cold storage. One of the employees will bring it back to the grinder, grind it up. Then it goes to the mixer, mix spices in with it, and then it goes to one of the three extruders that we have. And we can do any shape or size you want of it. You know, from a 1 ounce link, breakfast link, to a continuous rope, a tying rope. Where we blend our spices. We look over here, we have our spice rack or spice bins. Look right here, this is my great grandmother right here, Anna Polidori. She came over, these are the two boats that her and her husband came over on. Then met in Magna, Utah, and then moved to Denver because my great grandfather had black lung disease. These two guys right here, my great uncle and my grandfather, took the business over from my grandmother in 48, and in 1991 I bought it out. Or I started working for my grandfather in 91, and in 2000 I bought it out.
So Augie and Lou.
Augie and Lou.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm gonna come back over here. And you can see three generations. So my grandfather, my great-grandmother, and that's my father right there.
Wow.
And then we moved here in 2015. We used to be in North Denver.
I can't believe you had this entire business running in the
out of that little place
in
shoe
North
box
Denver.
That we were in.
Yeah, it's incredible. No wonder.
We made it work. We had to utilize cold storage outside the facility in order to do it. So.
Yeah, this is amazing.
Let's go taste it.
Yes, sir.
This is our test kitchen.
So, Stevie, I remember when I met you in the 90s and your the grocery store that your grandma started and was still there. Is it still on Shoshone?
It's still in Shoshone. Somebody had bought it and actually turned it into a loft. The store is still there. So let's go over here. Let's have a taste of it.
Taste it.
That looks fantastic. Smells fantastic. Beautiful.
At least they hold. You guys a little piece of the broth here first. Malt the bag.
That's so good. Tambora with RE/MAX Leaders, and I am so excited to show you around one of my very favorite spots, Southlands in the Southeast Aurora area. This is the heartbeat of this community. So we're going to start by meeting with my very favorite teammate, Laura Cantalamessa, and then I'm going to introduce you to a restaurateur with a very special concept. Hi, Laura.
Hi, Laurie. It's good to see you. It's good to see you.
Thank you for joining me.
Yeah, thank you. It's cold.
It's freezing.
Yes.
Winter's here.
Oh.
But winter is a really great time at Southlands.
It's so much fun, so much opportunity, and so many things to do. We've got an ice rink. All the restaurants around here are fantastic. It's really the epicenter of these neighborhoods that we always get so many phone calls for. You've got your high-end shops, fantastic restaurants, and bakeries and boutiques. It's really awesome.
Well, I am gonna go meet the owner of the Wine Experience. As you can see, Southlands is such a fun, special place, but now we're gonna go dig a little bit deeper at the Wine Experience Cafe. Hi, Eldon, how are you?
Hi, welcome to Wine Experience. Thanks for coming today.
I'm so excited.
Got a nice little wine to try while I show you my restaurant.
Paso Robles, California.
Exactly. This
is the Great Central Coast.
It's called Pure Paso. It's made with Syrah and Cabernet Sauvignon.
That's awesome. So we have a lot to talk about.
Awesome.
You have quite a unique concept here, and I want to be able to let everybody know as much as we can about what you do.
So we have two businesses. My wife owns the little wine shop next door, and I have the Wine Experience restaurant. Which is just across the little half wall, and so we kind of work together where people can taste wine here, and then they can go to my wife's shop and they can buy the wines over there. So I spent 30 years in the wholesale wine business, and then 15 years ago we started doing our marketing plan and putting together our own business, and then we opened up. So I've had the chance to travel all around the world, Australia, Europe, South America. I know a lot of the producers that we work with here at Wine Experience personally. Yeah. I've visited most of the regions, not all the regions, but most of the wine regions throughout the world. So we do a lot of fun things here, bringing what I've seen from around the world to Aurora.
Your menu is awesome. What are some of the all-time favorites?
You know, the menu is awesome because, one, everything is, you know, Chef and I sit down and plan the menu. It's not a huge menu, so we can make sure everything on is really special. My personal favorites, I like the calamari for our appetizers. I love our duck, really, really nice duck.
It was awesome getting to talk to you and learn a little bit more about the Wine Experience Cafe.
Awesome.
And we'll be seeing you soon, for sure.
We'll see you for live music, maybe
yes,
this weekend.
And happy anniversary.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed your tour of Southlands, and especially getting to learn about the really cool Wine Experience Cafe and cellar. Don't forget to book your private party, date night out, whatever it is, just make sure you get a chance to experience this. We'll see you next time on Selling Denver, American Dream. Tambora with RE/MAX Leaders. And today we're going to get serious. We're going to talk about a topic that's not so fun, but after the Marshall fires, we unfortunately realized that a lot of homeowners did not have enough insurance to replace their homes. So I'm going to take you in to meet a friend and colleague of mine. We're going to go through some of the nuts and bolts on what to do, how to make sure that your insurance policy, your homeowner's insurance policy, will cover you in the event of a disaster. And yeah, it's not a super fun topic, but I think it's very, very valuable. And can't wait for you to meet Paula. She's super funny. Come on in. Hi, Paula.
Hey, Mari. Good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you so much for doing this. This is going to be such a big deal and such a value add for our clients, friends, and family.
My pleasure. You know, we've talked about homeowners insurance so much, and roofs and coverage A. I'm so happy to be able to explain this to you.
Yeah.
Especially now because of the Marshall fires. Yeah. Everyone's asking.
Now's the time.
Come on, let's sit down. Okay. And I'll tell you all about it.
Okay. First-time home buyers obviously need mm-hmm. to be guided every step of
yes.
the way. Seasoned homeowners probably need to be guided more because they're so used to the way that, you know, they basically say, here's my insurance agent, and yeah. I don't know what kind of discussions there are about coverage other than they get the details about the home. Here's the age, here's the upgrades.
Yep.
So I would love for us to focus on how can we educate our clients from the beginning on how to make sure that they're covered.
What a great leading question. So, as an insurance agent, it's our responsibility to make sure that you're covered. So, what we often offer, but people rarely take advantage of, is called the personal insurance review. It's up to us and you to make sure that you're protected properly. What we use is a replacement cost calculator. Basically, every company will have their version of it. We use a computer program that, based on the features and the square footage of your home and cost of goods, that's calculated weekly, how much would it cost to rebuild your home? Most insurance companies actually give you a little bit extra in case we missed wainscoting, in case there's inflation, God forbid there is a tragedy such as what we had, but you really do need to keep it up to date. It's really your responsibility and ours to make sure that's updated so you don't get caught short. You won't have enough money to rebuild the home.
So another topic in real estate that I see all the time are the roofs.
When anyone calls in for a home quote, the first question I ask, how old is your roof? Mm-hmm. Because we have so many health claims in the state of Colorado, many of the major companies have gone to a 15-year kind of cutoff for replacement cost. Mm-hmm. So that means typically a roof, they say, a typical composition shingle roof has about a 30-year shelf life. Mm-hmm. So after about 15 years, it's half old. Mm-hmm. So they will give full replacement cost minus your deductible for 15 years.
Okay.
Your 16 to 30, it's half old and depreciates every year.
Yeah.
So it's super, super important to find out the age of your roof as you are buying that home, because you want to see how many years left of full replacement cost you have.
Thank you, Paula, so much. I really think that that is going to be valuable for our friends and family and clients.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Yeah, hopefully they learned a few things today, and it's so important. Thanks for coming up here. Yep. Really appreciate it. Anytime.
Hey,
let's do it again.
All right. Well, I hope you learned something today on this episode. It's always fun to bring you beautiful properties and neighborhood hotspots and lots of bling, but sometimes it's important to get serious and, you know, bring you some facts and advice that could change your life. So don't forget to call your insurance agent right away, schedule your annual review, and do it again every year. We'll see you next time on Selling Denver, American Dream. Oh. Driven by desire. Hometown hero haunts the main street, dreaming desperate dreams. Whoa, where there's smoke, there's fire. And some believe that love is one, and some of them go like they're under the gun. In between what's already done and the promise they feel in the evening to come. I'm for the small town, hot summer nights, radio about to blow. Top down, under the lights, feel the heat. Wild and sweet, hot summer
stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave their right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the